بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are here to commemorate the Shahada of Third Bab al-Hawaj. First Bab al-Hawaj we have in our history is the one who was in this world for 6 months. He could not speak, but whoever comes to his door, he listens to what he says. And second Bab al-Hawaj we have when he left the earth, he had no arms, he had no hands. Yet whoever goes to his shrine does not come back empty hands. Then we have third Bab al-Hawaj, Musa bin Ja'far al-Qasim. Imam al-Qasim, we always say al-Qasim, but what does it mean when we say al-Qasim? Imam is so mazloom that we are unable to celebrate his zuhur. Imam arrived in this world on 7th of Safar, 128 Hijri. We are not able to celebrate his zuhur. Why? Pak Sayyida has not left the morning room. She is still sitting there. And most of his time Imam has spent was under oppression. Imam is the only Imam, and not one, not two, but five different Khalifas of Abbasid ruled over Imam.
Marmamun Rashid, Harun Rashid, Lamad,
Beshmar.
Imam alayhi salam was born on 7th of Safar. Their mother, Hamida, when she was due to give birth, she sent a message to Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq to say, come in, I want you to be with me during the difficult time. When Imam came, and Imam was in the room, when Imam Sadiq arrived at this boat, and Imam al-Sadiq said this one thing, oh my son, you do nothing but like Kareemullah. You remind me, you resemble like Hazrat Musa. Now, we go back to history when they say that Panchtan Pak were there when the earth was created. I will go a step beyond that. No, not only Panchtan Pak. The entire Ahlul Bayt was there. Because Imam al-Sadiq says nothing but truth. And he says, my son, you resemble nothing but Hazrat Musa. Means when Hazrat Musa arrived at his world, Imam al-Sadiq was present. And Imam Musa al-Qasim is the only Imam whose name is not from the family of Ahlul Bayt. If you look at the Al-Ulaimah, they are the Muhammad Ali Hassan Hussein, the Ja'far, Ja'far bin Sadiq, they are the name of Imam Ali's brother. So the everyone in the family, beside Ahlul Musa al-Qasim. Why do they call Qasim? Everyone has a title. Why are they called Qasim? You call Qasim is a title given to the one who reaches the capacity of patience. Imam had so much patience that patience broke down and they were given the name of Qasim. When Imam and Qasim, they were 5 years old, Abu Hanifa, which is now one of the largest sect in Sunni Muslims, Abu Hanifa came to the door of Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq and said, oh my son, I want to speak to your father about I have one issue. And Imam Qasim said, I can help you, what's the problem? And he asked three questions. When we commit a sin, as we know, whatever we do is already done for us. Because when we commit a sin, is Allah making us do the sin? Or is Allah part of the crime? Or Allah is unaware of the sin? And Imam replied, because Imam said, if Allah was making us do the sin, that's against his divine justice to punish us for doing the sin, if he's making us do the sin. If he was part of the sin, again it would be against his divine justice. Allah is watching us, but he left us free to say, can you control your nafs? If you are, then of course you are free. If you're not, then you are slave. One day Imam alayhi salam, he had a neighbor, he was a farmer, he was a non-believer. He used to cuss Imam all the time. And all Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, he used to cuss them all the time. And one day Imam alayhi salam went to his farm and he said, what are you doing? And he started shouting at Imam alayhi salam. He started cursing Imam. Imam ignored him. walked up to him and he said, "Assalamu alaikum." He said, "What are you doing here? You have messed up with my class, they were my bread and butter, etc." The Imam said, "I heard you are in trouble." So that all said, "Nothing to do with you. Mind your own business." The Imam said, "How much do you need?" He said, "I need 200 dinars." And the Imam said, "How much did it cause the damage?" He said, 100 dinars. The Imam gave him a pot which had 300 dinars in it. The Imam knew his troubles. And when he opened the pot, he said, "How much is it?" The Imam said, "Your shortfall is in there." And when he counted, 300, and he said, "What kind of man are you? I'll shout at you, I swear at you and your family. And today you come in here looking after me, though I'm in hardship." And Imam replied, "That's you and that's me. That's the difference between you and the difference between me." At the time when Imam Ja'far Sadiq was departing his soul, Mansur was a planner. When he knew that Imam is about to go, he sent a letter to his Khalifa of the time in Medina and said, "And Ja'far is going. Whoever is the successor in his will, kill him." Now this is a shaitan against a masoom. Imam made the will, and Ibrahim, who was the governor of Medina at that time, he got off the will. The instructions were, first successor, if not second, kill them. So when he got off the will, Imam Asadiq, he left first successor to be Mansur himself. Second successor to be Ibrahim himself. So he got the third was Hamidah and fourth was Imam al-Qasim. He got the bill, he sent it off to Mansur. He said, "Mansur, what do you say now? Do I proceed with your orders? If I do, your head is the first one. Then it's me and then Hamidah, then al-Qasim." He said, "No, ignore it. Ignore my instructions and do what they want." And Imam al-Qasim, he has spent, said, five different khalifas came one after the other. Starting from Muhammad Salah, he was the first Abbasi Khalifa at the time. He was known to be as a bloodshedder. He had no mercy. Then followed by Mansur, followed by Hadi, then Mahdi, and the last one, Harun Rashid. When Harun came in the rest of Hadi and Mahdi, they said to Imam, "You do your business, we do ours. Let's not interfere in each other's, and we live happily." Yet Hadi got Imam into faith later on in his life. When Imam received orders from Harun to say, "Come visit us," Imam ignored him. Imam's cousin, his name was Ali, he received a letter from Harun to say, "Come visit me, I've got something for you." And when he was leaving, Imam's cousin said to him, "Ali, don't go. Where are you going?" He said, "No, I have to go to a city because I have some work to do. I can't find work here. I need to find work." Imam said, "How much do you need? I'll give you employment." He said, "No, I have to leave. I have to leave." And Imam said, "Whatever you do, don't become the reason of my death." And Imam gave him a pot of gold. He said, "Go, you might need it." And he had the greed from Harun to say, "I will look after you. I'll make you a multimillionaire." When he got there, he met Harun, he gave all the insights out of Imam, and Harun gave him a pot of gold. When he came out of the palace, he opened the pot. Imam Asadiq gave him 300 dinars, Harun gave him 200. And at that time, when he saw it, he goes, "What have I done? For money which is less than what Musa gave me, I have conspired his murder." Some narrations say he died on the way. Some say he never went back to Medina because he was ashamed to meet Imam al-Qasim. Moving on, Imam al-Qasim, when they were arrested, they spent 35 years. Imam was Imam. His life was 56 years. And 35 years they were Imam, largest of all those Imams. And out of 35 years, 14 years were spent in prison. Not in one prison, not in one city, not in one country. Imam was taken from one country to another, one city to another. When Harun said to put him in one jail, the governor of the jail, he became Muslim. He went to next jail. Same thing happened. People say, who are you telling us to kill? He does nothing but recite Quran or do namaz. How can we kill him? Then Harun got a plan that he got some ladies to go into the prison. They said, look, Imam has a bad character. They went in, they spent some time with Imam. When they all came back, all of them were Muslims. Harun said, what happened to you? He said, you told us to raise questions of the character of a man who never even looked at us. Whenever we go there, he's doing nothing but sujood. How can we raise this opinion on his character? We can't do it. And Harun got people who were outside of Arab, who never spoke Arabic. So he said, okay, now Imam doesn't speak nothing but Arabic. Maybe they will do the job. They got him. 3 days later, they come back out. They all come Muslim. And Harun said, what happened to you? He said, well, he spoke our language. He told us what we are here for. He knew why we're coming in. And towards the later stage of Imam's life, Imam moved to one prison where there was no daylight. Imam never knew what the sun looked like. Imam was standing. Throughout the time in that prison, Imam was standing. Imam requested the governor, said, can you please remove the stone from the top? I want to know when is Fajr time, when is Zuhr time, so the prayer time. Each time they removed the stone, they threw rubbish on Imam. The prison was so tight that Imam was not able to sit. And then later on they said, okay, this is not working, let's move him to a different place. They moved Imam to last prison. Imam could not stand. Imam could not sit. Throughout the time in that prison, Imam wasn't ruku. If we spend more than 2 minutes in ruku, our back starts to hurt. Just imagine how Imam spent all those years in that prison, doing nothing but sujood. How he was eating, how he was drinking, how he was performing his salahs, how he was sleeping. That's beyond imagination. That's why Imam is given the title of Al-Fazl, because patience broke down in front of Imam Al-Fazl. When Imam was given poison, the news reached Medina to say, Imam had 38 children, 20 sons and 18 daughters. And of course, we know two mainly, Imam Al-Raza al-Sana, Imam Abi Masum al-Kum. When they got the news that Imam is soon to be poisoned, Imam Raza, he got the news from Ghaiba that Imam is poisoned, he's soon to be gone. People start to talk about where who's going to be next Imam, who's going to be next Imam. The Masuma left her home in the search for her father. Imam Raza left his home in search for a place to escape from Harun. And on the day of the 25th of Rajab, when Imam left the world, normally when we talk about Qaid, we think about Imam Sajjad. He had chains from his neck to his feet and his arms. But Imam Sajjad was able to stand up with those chains. Some say he was kind of ruku in the chains. But he had no cannons attached to his chains. Imam Al-Qasim, he had cannons, metal balls attached to the chains, so that he doesn't stand up. When we try to hold something which weighs 5 kg or more, our hands start to hurt. And that's Imam Al-Qasim.